was your approach with Steve Vai going in there with
Steve Vai? Wow. It was just do what he asked me to do. He sent me that fire garden suite like FedEx did a couple days before. Right. And I didn't do email at that time. I called him, and I'm not sure if the first thing out of my mouth to Steve was, ha, 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 very funny. Sending me, you know, this epic song. Like, what, am I going to learn it on the plane? You know, and I'm like, dude, but he
can do that.
He's
no
funny
problem.
Like that. Yeah. He's a pusher, and I like that. But I also, we got along well because he knew that I appreciated that he knew what he was talking about, first of all.
Right.
And that I think he appreciated being able to tell me what to do, like everything. Like, can you not hit that cymbal? Can you hit this one instead?
Yeah.
And then he started to test me. Go, well, can you play an 11 tuplet in this? Can I play an 11 tuplet? he knew I would do that. Go, what? What do you mean? You want the seventh note on the splash? Yeah, hit it. He goes, no, try the bell. No, try that splash. Yes, hit that one. But the thing is, we got along and giggled and we had a ball. I just love that about him. Absolutely loved it. And I don't think most people like being told what to do all the time. I mean, there's times when I would like to play what comes to mind, you know. Mm-hmm. But it depends on who's hiring you and who's paying the bill, what's the job, what's your role, what are the boundaries, you know. So I enjoyed that. But that's what my experience is, recording the Fire Garden Suite. And it was originally called Fire Coma.